even one single alter should work well. Because if that is the individual attribute or attitude towards the audit of professionalism, then I think rotation is just a precaution taken to ensure that in case a longer acquaintance with the system, there might be a lethargy or complacency, and therefore the auditors finance or CFO can miss something. And therefore having a new view on the audit is always beneficial. But the basic assumption should not be that that relationship for a longer period may actually get that cozy relationship kind of concept. And therefore my belief is that peer review is one of the major tools, because peer review always has a advantage of somebody of the partner of the audit firm who's signing the balance sheet. He or she is being reviewed by their peers within the same firm. And if that is done, I think that complacency or a little bit of lethargy, or I would call it professional lethargy, may be avoided. Or many times it so happens that you are so used to those numbers, looking at them for years together, you are likely to miss out something which has happened outside the company or in the industry. And those sort of inputs are not taken into account. And therefore, maybe peer review can add that value. And my suggestion always would be, peer review may not be from the same firm, but peer review from the another firm, just reviewing the audit work of a particular partner is very, very important. But rotation of auditors sometimes gives a little bit of hardships even to the company and audit firm, because every time then you have to bring the new audit partner to the level of domain knowledge, because the person may not be aware of the company, person may not be aware of the industry, and therefore it takes a longer efforts to ensure that the new gentleman comes has to be brought up to a level of domain knowledge of the company or the industry or the business, and then start doing audit. So there are merits and demerits, but my stronger view is that rotation of auditors probably creates some more doubts, but the peer review probably is a better professional tool in our hand to ensure that those complacencies, lethargies, cozy relationship, or whatever the name you gave, actually gets created because of the longer relationship. At the same time, you are taking advantage of the domain knowledge of a person. At the same time, you are avoiding those demerits of longer relationship. You can achieve it rather than having the rotation of auditors. So my belief is peer review within the same firm partner or external firm partner is a better way to look at it. Well, I think I would, very bluntly, if you ask me, I think we're adding one more confusion, because there is international accounting standards, there are Indian standards. Instead of chartered accountants keeps on issuing the guidelines, and now we got an NFRA, which is one more authority. My fear is always if they issue the contradicting views between Institute of Chartered Accountants and NFRA, then the auditors and CFOs might be in a kind of a dilemma. I hope that that kind of situation doesn't arise. But accounting ultimately has a lot of interpretations, the way in which transactions are treated. And if every time you have a different treatment envisaged because of each authority or each institution has a different interpretation, then I think all of us will be in trouble, in the sense that interpreting the numbers would be more and more difficult. So my hope is that both Institute of Chartered Accountants, Institute of Internal Auditors, and the NFRA work together to ensure that they come out with some synchronized interpretations and policies. And my also hope is that they should not just recommend, but they should make guidelines mandatory, as what is done in most of the developed countries, that you have to follow and not just recommend it. And don't give two or three recommendations that I can pick up either of them. But looking at the domain, looking at the business requirement, I think they should come out with a clear guidelines on each side or each industry, because accounting transaction can be the same, but each industry may be treating differently. Then I think that needs to be respected, needs to be understood, and accordingly that should be given. The guidelines should be formed, because otherwise it will be like in pharma industry, that you give the same paracetamol to everyone thinking that the results will be same. But that's not the case. Each body is different, each industry is different, and their problems are different. The way in which they need to treat the accounts to give the fair view is different. And wherever the judgmental calls come, especially for the management, like depreciation or amortization, I think the views between Income Tax, Companies Act, NFRA, all they should be in sync. And rather than keeping the separate books and reconciling and creating deferred tax assets and liabilities, I think if they all synchronize and interpret the same way and ensure that each industry gets benefit out of it without complication or without confusion. And ultimately, again, as I said, the shareholders and the investors in the market get the clear picture of the numbers, and they don't get confused by how to interpret each balance sheet in the same industry given by each company, because they have chosen different options. So NFR is welcome, but at the same time, they should take into account the industry domain, the industry requirement of each domain, and at the same time go in synchronization or synchronized way with other institutes like Institute of Chartered Accountants to ensure that there is no confusion or there is no double or other interpretations of the same recommendation, and therefore each one can interpret it differently like Bhagavad Gita and then conclude differently, and therefore each number will mean different thing. I think we should avoid that. If that can be achieved, I think NFR is most welcome. But clearly, I thought instead of Chartered Accountants trying to do that job, but clearly government failed the need for it, or maybe industry may have failed the need for it, because maybe institute was lagging somewhere behind and just giving recommendations and not mandatory. So maybe NFRA would start giving the mandatory requirements, ensuring that there is no further confusion, and add value to the numbers that we publish.